In this video, I'm going to walk you through completing Lab2. You should already have SQL Server Management Studio installed, so if you haven't done that yet, be sure to go back to Lesson 1 and follow the instructions there. I've logged into Desire to Learn and I'm on the course homepage, so I'm going to go to the Content tab and select Lesson 2 and click on the Dropbox for Lab2 Week 2. This includes a template SQL file that you're going to be filling out for your lab. And I'm going to click on it to open it. So SQL Server Management Studio pops up. I get the connection dialog, server name, CIS, dbss.pcc.edu. Login is 275 student, password is 275 student. So I connect. Asked me twice, once for this and once for that. Okay, but here I am. I'm connected to the database. You should see the fired up database, and this is the one that we're going to be working with. So here are the tables in the fired up database. And I'm going to get rid of this because we don't really need it for this video. And I'm just going to work through this. So I'll fill in my name under consent, and I'll put the date in. And there are only 5 questions in this one, so it should be pretty quick. So the first one, write the query to project everything, all columns, all rows from the customers table. Now, just to make it a little more interesting for you, I'm going to do a little bit different problem. I'm going to project all the information from the employee table instead of the customer table. And hopefully you'll be able to figure out the correct query for customers. And to test this, I'm going to go ahead and select the query and hit the execute button. And here's all of the columns, project all of the columns, and select all of the rows from the employee table. For question 2, project the serial number, type, version, and color for all rows in the stove table. So here's the stove table, and we can look at the columns, and it's asking for serial number, type, version, and color for all rows. I'm going to go to the part table and I'm going to select the part number, description, and sales price instead. So for my query, I'm going to say select part number. And let me use a tab here so everything lines up nicely. Description and sales price, and this is going to be from the part table. So let me execute this query, and here are those 3 columns from the part table for all rows. Question 3, display the part number and description for all parts, show results in ascending order of sales price. Now I just did a query on the part table, so this time let me go for the employee table again, and I'm going to select the employee ID and name, and then I'm going to show results in ascending order by employee ID. So select emp ID and name. From employee, and then to show results in ascending order, I'm going to say order by, and then the column that I want to order by. Now, the default order is ascending order, so I don't have to do anything else. I can just run the query, and the results are ordered by employee ID. I get the same thing if I say ASC for ascending. And if I wanted to sort into descending order, I could use DESC. See, now it's descending order by emp ID. So that's how you order results in ascending or descending order. Write a query to display the description and sales price for part number 569. So I'm going to write a query that displays the emp ID name and initials for employee number 6. So emp ID name initials from employee where emp ID is equal to 6. So this is how I select one row. And there's employee ID 6, employee ID name and initials. Display everything from the part table which has a cost greater than $1. Rename each column using the as keyword. So this time I'm going to go to the stove table. And I want to display everything from the stove table which has a cost greater than. Actually, I want, let's see. Let me go to the stove type table instead because that has prices in it. Okay, so this has a price column. This one's a little more complicated, so I'm going to refresh myself about what the data looks like. Select star from stove type. And then let's say I want to select all of the stoves where the price is greater than 100. Now, I don't put a dollar sign here, even though it's a price, because as far as the database is concerned, it's just a number here. All right, so these are the stoves with the price greater than 100. And then I want to rename each column using as. So first, I want to select each column. So I want type version price, that should be all three of these columns. Still works. And now I'm going to use as to rename them. So type as stove type version as stove version and price as stove price. All right, so I've selected all the stove types with price greater than 100, and I've used as to rename all the columns. So that's it for Lab 2. Now to finish the lab, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to save my file, and I downloaded it to my downloads folder, so I'll just save it there. And now I'm going to go back to Desire to Learn, scroll down a little bit. Under Submissions, it says Upload. I'm going to click that button. I'm going to go to my Downloads folder, and right at the top, the most recent download is lab-week2.sql. And then I'm going to hit Submit to Dropbox. And that's all there is to it. Your lab should be uploaded. Expect to see feedback on the Dropbox folder after I've taken a look at it. Good luck!